You can now subscribe for direct access to all our shows online at youtube.com/uprisingwithsonali. Your subscription sustains the TV production of Uprising. A federal jury in Manhattan yesterday awarded the families of dozens of people $218 million in damages in a first-of-its-kind terrorism case. The Palestinian Authority and the Palestine Liberation Organization were held liable for supporting the actions of several attacks between the years 2002 and 2004 in Israel, which harmed or killed U.S. citizens. While the PA and PLO have long maintained that U.S. courts have no jurisdiction over them, the case went ahead anyway. The trial lasted 7 weeks and featured emotional testimony from survivors and victims' relatives in six attacks that left nearly three dozen people dead and hundreds injured. Among the incidents was a 2002 bombing of a cafe at Hebrew University in Jerusalem, in which nine people were killed, among them five U.S. students. Because the case was brought under a special terrorism law, the damages are automatically tripled to $655 million. In recent months, the Palestinian Authority has been crippled by Israel, withholding tax revenues owed to it in retaliation against a PA bid for statehood at the United Nations. My guest is Charlotte Silver. She is an independent journalist who writes for Electronic Intifada and Al Jazeera English, and she's been following this case. Welcome to Uprising, Charlotte.
Thank you so much. It's great to be here.
Now, what sort of precedence does this case set, and how can a U.S. court even collect damages from international entities?
Well, this isn't the first time that a U.S. court has determined that the PA could be held responsible for what appears to be other individual acts of violence or terrorism, as it's being called in this context. But it is the first time that a jury has awarded damages on the basis of this liability. And the evidence in the case, what the case was supposed to prove was that the Palestinian Authority and the PLO had specifically planned and executed the six attacks at the core of the case that had killed the 33 people and injured hundreds more. But what it did more so was sort of prove a relationship that the PA had set up, sort of a system of awards to men and fighters who participated in the bombings and shootings, and it was much more vague than actually proving a direct connection to the specific acts. So the precedent that it could potentially set is that any so-called terrorist acts that occurred while the PA was in control during the Second Intifada could be traced back to the PA, which could potentially open up more civil litigation against the Palestinian political bodies.